couch.me guitar lessons.
Hey there, Lickin' Riffers. Welcome to yet another awesome fingerstyle arrangement lesson right here on Lickin' Riff. And this time you're in for a real treat because we're going to learn the classic song Tomorrow from Annie. First, I'm going to play it for you so you can see and hear how it goes. And then we're going to break it down step by step, chord by chord, note by note with tabs right here on the screen. It goes like this. Enjoy. So whenever you're ready, put on a C chord and play strings 4, 5, 4, 3, 2. And the pause there was intentional. Okay? You play the E note first and then you play the arpeggio. Then you play the E string. Then you play 3 and 2 on strings 2 and 5. Okay? You can play the whole set of chords, strings 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, this is G over B. And then you play 1 on the 2nd string. So, and again, make it expressive. And then you play an F major 7 chord. Okay, you can play the E string again before that. Okay, so it's 0, 1, 2, 3 on strings 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, and then you have 3, 1, 0 on the 2nd string, 2 on the 3rd. And then 3-0 on the 2nd string, and when you play the open 2nd string, you can play an E minor chord with it, or just the E bass, the low 6th string. So, okay, you can put on the E minor, and play it with this open 2nd string. So it's F major 7, and then, okay, 3-1-0 on the 2nd, 2 on the 3rd, 3 on the 2nd, and then the open 2nd string with E minor. Then you put on an A minor chord and you play strings 4 and 5 and then 1 on the 2nd string. Okay? Now again, you want it to be very, very expressive, so you can even slide into 2 on the 4th string if you wanna. So, you can do that. And then you have A minor over G. So you can just play the G bass, 3 on the 6th string, or you can play A minor with G. You can you can arpeggiate with G on the 6th string. This is A minor 7, just with the minor 7 on the bass. So, and then 3 on the 2nd string, open E string, and then you have F. Now, you bar the F. Okay, you put on the bar on the 1st fret and the E-shaped chord, okay, the barred F. And the first time around, you play the 4th string as your low note with the bass, with the 6th string. Okay, you can play strings 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so it's... Okay, this is the first ending. And then you start by playing this. Okay, so it's almost the same as the first time you played the C chord. But you're playing the F note again. 3 on the 4th. Then you put on the C chord and you hammer on the 2 on the 4th string. Okay, now instead of playing a country double stop, I play it right after the other. Okay, one right after the other. It's called a phlegm in music. Okay, when you play them almost together. Okay, so that's what I do. I play the 3 on the 5th with the hammer-on on the 2 on the 4th. Almost together. Okay, one after the other. Ta-da-da. Okay, so you have to practice that. Right effect, and then you play everything again. G over B, F major 7, E minor, A minor, over G, and then 3 on the second open E, and then F with the high E string on 1. Okay, and you can just play the whole chord, just arpeggiate it, play lavish ornamental ending to the verse. So that's the verse. And then you have this. Okay, the open third string 3 times. 1-3 on the second string. And then immediately you put on C minor. Okay, bar on 3 A minor shape. And you play the whole chord. Okay, strings 2 to 5. 4 on the second string, that's your note there. Then you have just a little bit of time to arpeggiate, and then you have the 5 on the third string, which is in the chord. Okay, it's in the chord, 5 on the third, and then you have this 4 and 1 on strings 2 and 5, just a little bit of a stretch, and then you play the open fourth, open third, and then 1 on the second string, and immediately you bar the fourth fret for G. G sharp. Okay, so yeah, you play strings 2, 3, 4, and 6. You slide it 2 frets up to A sharp or B flat, and you pick it again. Strings 2, 3, 4, and 6. Okay, so once again, right? That's the line. Then you have. An arpeggio of this chord, the B flat chord. Strings 4, 4, 4, 3, 2. And then D sharp or E flat. Okay, bar on 6, A shape. So you can double bar it. Play strings 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, on 8, 8, 8, and 6. And then the 8 on the third string. And then you have to put on D sharp major 7. So it's 8, 7, 8. And 6 on the 5th string. And then you just lay your finger down for 8 on the 3rd string again. And then you have this. Okay, G sus to G. So you put on a G chord with 1 on the 2nd string. You play it lavishly. Then I'm playing the chord. Then I play an arpeggio strings 3, 2, 1. And then I open the 2nd string. Okay, and then you have the verse again. So let's just recap what's going on here. Okay, C minor. Okay, this is G minor over B flat. And then D sharp. D sharp major 7. And then G sus. You have the verse again. You can hammer on. I put the minor. And then you play 3 on the second string and the open E string, but instead of playing F, you play this. you put the bar on one, on strings 1, 2, and 3, and play 3 and 4 on strings 4 and 5. This is C#7. What a beautiful, beautiful harmonic change there. This is so great. This is a hallmark of Broadway musicals, where you change this into this. This is terrific. This is a great substitution. You play it lavishly, however you want to play it, very expressively, try to feel the chord, and then you play a G chord. You're back to the G chord. I start by playing the open second string, okay? And then I play the G chord. Because that's a motif, that's what we did with the G sus. Okay, so I do the same move, but with two chords. So that's the ending here for the second verse. Now the chorus. This is probably the most challenging part. Okay, now the first thing you have to know here is to play this. Okay. Open first and third strings. Then you put the third and fourth fingers on 5 on strings 1 and 3. Then you put fingers 3 and 4, right, on 3 and 4 on strings 1 and 3. Okay, so it's, okay, on strings 1 and 3, it's 0, 5, and 3 and 4. You need the 4-finger free, okay, because you're gonna play a bass line. So with the first 5, you play 3 on the 5th. And then you move it. Now, you might ask, I can bar it, so I can just play 4 on the 3rd string and play the 3 that's already in the bar. That's right, but you can do that the next 2 chords. So, you can do this the first time using the bar, but the second time you have to do it, because you have the B bass, 2 on the 5th instead of 3. So you can not bar and use your 2 fingers, and then do the same thing, okay, with 2. Then you have 1 on the 5th string, the B flat. So it's a bit of a stretch. Okay, so hey, even I can't hold it right now. Kind of have to be in the moment to pull it off. And then you have this. Okay? This time it's F. It's 1 on the 6th string, and it's 0, and then 3 and 3. Right? And then 1 and 1, just the bar, on strings 1 and 3. Now you can add, okay, you can add a Tommy Emmanuelism. Okay? 3 slide to 4 slide to 3 there. You like. And then you have 2 endings. Sorry, not yet. You have 3 on the 2nd string, then you have a C chord with 1-0 on the E string, 1 on the B string. And then you have you have a G7 chord. You have the open 3rd string with 3 and 3 on strings 4 and 6. So you can just play the open 3rd string and then the G7. And then you have 2 endings. The first ending is 3 on the 2nd string and then C with 1. Then you play the whole thing again. Ah. If you want. And then second ending, you can add the harmonic there if you want. So it's 3 on the E string and then C with 3 on the E string. Again, very expressively, and you can add the harmonic. Okay, just extend your finger, touch the string, the E string, above the 15th fret, because it's 12 frets above the 3, and pick it with the third finger or the little finger. So. And then you get the harmonic. And that's your arrangement for tomorrow. So before you go, download the tab, which is free. The link is below in the description. Subscribe to the channel. I don't see a reason why not. There's hundreds of lessons here, literally, and it's all for free. So go download the tab, which is also for free. But if you want to give something back anyway, there's a donation button on the website or in the description, a Patreon link. So whatever you choose to give back to Lick and Riff goes right back into Lick and Riff, into your guitar education. And I'm grateful for any donation whatsoever, for any support. And I thank you in advance for your generosity. So in the meantime, you go practice this, and I'll see you the next lesson. Bye for now. Enjoy.